Hey Lego Fanatics, Zach the Lego Fanatic here, and today I'm going to be reviewing the Lego 40th year anniversary of the Lego Train promotional set. Now this is set number 4370, it's 188 pieces, and is recommended for ages 9+. Now this item is a GWP, and that means gift for purchase, when you spend $99 at the Lego, $99 or more at the Lego store, when you purchase any item from March 1st through the 15th. So now if you still want to pick up this promo, that means it is still going on. And just want to point out that this is why supplies last. So if your store runs out, you're out of luck. But you could also go do Lego shop online, not just in stores. So first, let's take a look at the set right here. So you can see it comes with a display stand, a minifigure, and the train itself. Now a little backstory on this set. It is actually based off set number 7810, which was the steam train, very similar to this, and I think that was called the locomotive and push car, I think. And now this set had also included the minifigure, just not the display stand. Not only there's a few minor differences that when we take a look at the train, I will point out. So overall, this is a pretty good set. So first, let's take a look at the train. So here is the train, and it is a very close interpretation of set number 7810. And here's a picture of the 7810 train showing now. Now, a few minor differences I would like to point out are first here on the front. Now, the other train had different buffer pieces, and they were the actual buffers. And then it had a metal coupling here, but instead, this train does not use the metal coupling because maybe they decided that it would not make the train look like the original one. So that's the difference there. And the train also did have like the bufferings and the coupling on the back, but again, this promotional doesn't have none of the couplings, and it's brick built buffers instead of the piece that's buffers and the magnetic coupling. So another difference is with the logo here, which is, I'll show that picture again, is that here it has a newer Lego train symbol instead of the DB, which I guess was like a rail line Lego had back then. As you can see here, the white is Lego Technique connector peg instead of being put directly into the hole of this piece. And you see it has the same sticker right there, 7810, and it does keep that same set number 7810. And then also on the back here it says 7810, and the original probably said that. I can really see the picture. I'll see if I can find a picture, and if I do, I'll insert the picture in now. And now if you look on the inside of the train, maybe turn my flashlight on. You could see that it just goes straight in. There's like a whole bunch of space under there, and there's a small little control panel with three gauges, so you could check the speed and how much coal and how much the steam pressure and stuff like that in the train. And then moving on to the other side, it's that same identical to the other side, and then you can see there's, forgot to mention that there was ladders. Yep, and then it's got funnels, which has stayed the same to the original. And I really like this train because you see, it does, the wheels do move. So now let me show you how it fits with the track. So here, as you can see, the train is not just made for the display stand. It is made for tracks and rolls nicely along the tracks. Maybe with just a minor friction. And another thing is that the minifigure does fit inside the cap. Oops. So what you would have to do, and keep it on, is you would first have to remove the roof. And then you can put the minifigure in like that. You know, there's not many controls for the minifigure to use inside. Put that cap back on. I do like how these are used for the roof. And just the roof does have a nice design. I really like the design of this train. It's a really great steam train. So now let's take a look at the display stand. So here's the display stand. And as you can see, it just has two studs. This is what holds the train on. And then it has these things, so just make sure you don't push the train down too much. I might do like these 2x2 brick clear pieces because that's a rare piece. And then here it's a sticker that says 40 years, which is, and has the train. So this is the logo for the 40th year anniversary of the Lego train theme. Then here it says 7810 steam engine. So that's a nice touch. And this is on a hinge, so you could turn it like on a swing if you want more like museum plaque, or just put it like that, as it says in the instructions. But I like it better like this. Now this spot right here, well, that's for the, let's take the minifigure out of the train. this is for the minifigure right there. So that's where the minifigure would go. So now let's take a look at that minifigure. Well, here is that minifigure, and as you could see, so I have the flash range and actually turn it off for a second. Ah, that's actually worse. Anyway, so say, as you can see, it has a regular classic Lego minifigure face. And down the torso. Oh, this is not. I don't know. Sorry about that. I just adjusted my camera so you can see actually. So as you can see on the torso, it does have pockets right here. Is the pocket, so it's a part of the original train conductor outfit. Alright, it's just that the only difference between that and the original minifigure is that obviously the printing is more bright so you can see it better, and the plastic is better quality material than the original minifigure. But besides that, it's identical. It has the regular classic Lego face, a red conductor or policeman cap. So I do like these classic torsos with the buttons and the two pockets and the collar. Nice little former train conductor outfit. And then it just has plain blue legs. Not much to say about this minifigure. No back printing. But it's a nice, really nice throwback to the old train conductor and driver minifigures. So now let's get to the final thoughts and packaging. So first, taking a look at the packaging, it's a white box, has a 40 years of Lego Train Anniversary logo, has the Lego System logo too, because that's what the demon was part of back then. And it shows the set, the minifigure, and it shows you ages 9 plus, set number 4370, 180 pieces Lego. Side again has the logo there. Oh, let me zoom out. Then on the back again, the Lego System logo shows you an inside of the train cab. Then here you also have here the train shows you could sort of put it right on the display stand. Shows again it's modeled off set number 7100, which came out in 1980. And that's a long time ago. That's a long time ago. It's a really nice throwback. And this actually reminds me of the 60 year anniversary of the Lego brick. So I do like this packaging. Reminds me of that box. By the way, here's a picture of the 60 year anniversary of the Lego brick set showing now. So now, let's get to my final thoughts on this set. So, in my opinion, this is a really great set, being that it's thrown back to the original Lego set that many of us are probably not around to be able to get, that we're not able to get because we probably weren't around then, or maybe you weren't into Legos. Now, I think a nice inclusion, I think this is literally very close to the original, some with minor modification changes, and the minifigure stayed the same besides brighter printing and better quality material. I do like the inclusion of the display stand so you can put it on display. And I really like the space on the inside of the train. Just like, overall, it's just a really nice looking set. And I think this is my favorite promotional set to date. That's not like not Star Wars or Marvel. So this one's really cool. So now, one thing I did want to show you is maybe how I think you could connect it to a regular train car. So I'll be right back. So here's my idea and how you can make this attached to other train cars and how you could get it motorized. So obviously, you know, the motor cannot fit in the train because it's just too small and it'd look weird if you try to modify it. So first I'm going to show you how to attach a coupling like this. So my suggestion is, first you want to take the roof off, you want to take this side panel, you want to remove this and that, remove this side panel, and you want to remove this like that. So then you would just remove this one temporarily, remove that temporarily, and you would have to do the same thing to the other side. So you would remove that, move it in sections, so that's just a better idea. Like that. And then again, remove these two. And move this. And then maybe put a 1x2 there and a 1x2 there. So then you could attach this by first. You would have to move the makeshift buffers. And then you can add this right here. So then it may look weird, but it still doesn't. You either leave that exposed Or what you could actually do is put like a 1x1 stud there. So let me go get them. So I was able to get these two pieces. Because this one was an extra piece from the train. This one is just an extra piece from another set I had. So since you won't see it on this side, I don't want to spend too much time finding a black one. So here, I'll put this there. And I'm going to put this one here. So what you do is you put the setup back together, which I'll skip ahead. So now that I put the train back together, so let's put that on the track. Now, here's my idea for motorized. You may be thinking, Zach, how are you going to motorize the train? Because like you said before, that you can't put a motor inside a roller coaster if you modify. Well, if you have the Disney train, or you make a customized coal cart that has a motor inside, you could attach it to this train. See? Attach to this train, and since then you don't have to put a motor in the train. And then, easily now with the coal cart, you could just start attaching other train cars very easily to this train. And then, you may ask, why am I turning it on? It's because the phone I'm using right now is how I control the train, since this is this doesn't use remote control. I haven't been able to get one of those controls yet, so maybe in the future I'll get a control for the train. See? And you can easily connect to other train cars, and now you have a motorized steam train. So that's my idea on how to do that. So, I've been Zach the Lego Fanatic. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I hope you can actually find this idea and maybe incorporate it into your Lego train setup or into your Lego city. So, now, I'm Zach the Lego Fanatic, so I hope you enjoyed the video, and thanks for watching. And remember, if you've not yet already, to give this video a big thumbs up, subscribe to my channel for more content like this, and comment below your thoughts on this set, and what you think of my idea. So, I'm Zach the Lego Fanatic, hope you enjoyed the video, thanks for watching, Zach out!